I'm Todd Ogasawara, the good Dr. Jon Westfall. This is mini podcast 45, and it's going to be a short one. I had to bother Jon so I could test my new Surface Pro Copilot Plus PC. So this is the Snapdragon Plus, not the Elite, not the high-end fancy one, but it's what I felt I could afford. And I really wanted to just test the camera. So I'm looking at the built-in camera under Surface Pro right now. And I'm using the Array microphone that's built into the Surface Pro also. So I'm going to switch the microphone to my, let's see, what do I switch it to? I'm going to switch it to my Yeti Nano. So that's this thing right here. So I'm now Yeti Nano. Can you hear the difference, by the way, Jon?
You went a little bit, it is a higher quality switch to go to the Yeti Nano. That's not surprising, but it's not as dramatic as you would think. You
really
have a little bit cleaner of a sound through the Yeti and a little bit more off the background noise. But the Array was actually surprisingly pretty good. I did not think that it was, I didn't think it was the Yeti Nano, but I also didn't think it was really a cheap built-in microphone.
Yeah, and when Sven Johansson was demonstrating his Surface Pro, which is the Elite, I was really impressed by the sound that he was getting from the Array microphone. So I'm going to just switch back since we are just kind of testing this Pro. So I'm going to switch back to the Array microphone. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch the camera. So the camera we're using right now is the front-facing camera on the Surface Pro. And I'm going to a UVC-40, which is a, I think you can see me, which is a 4K camera. I'm staring off the screen. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the screen here. So I'm sort of looking at you versus whatever. Although the light is coming from this way because it's sitting on top of my Surface Pro. So the light probably looks a little different. I should note that the background on this was generated by Google Meet. The only thing I've turned on, the new feature, Copilot Plus PCs have a new feature where you can do a certain number of things using their, localized AI. And one of them is to make me look like I'm looking at the camera, even if I'm kind of not. Which is a really interesting problem, because most of us don't have cameras placed or don't know how to place the cameras. Like, I know I don't. So anyway, this is the 4K camera.
Speaking of weird features, I did notice since I started teaching again this week and I've been using my iPad Pro that I just picked up last month, that the Microsoft app for iPad now has a Copilot button if you are a Copilot subscriber.
Oh, really?
I did not notice that. Yeah, this is the first time I've seen it in the mobile version of a Microsoft Office product, because previously it had just been in the desktop versions. But yeah, now that I can actually, I'll send you kind of a screenshot of what it looks like. But it just kind of sits there out in the top, and I'm not sure exactly what to do with it yet, but it's starting to make its way in.
Well, I am going to move my Google Meet window back to the Surface Pro's main screen. There it is. And now I'm going to switch the camera back to the from my 4K camera to the Surface camera front. All right. So I'm back to the, I notice I'm really a lot smaller, even though I'm basically the same distance from both cameras, which is sort of interesting. I'm not sure why that is. Maybe it's a wider angle camera. Like, I have to get in really close to be like a headshot. I'm about 14, 15, 16 inches away from the camera. So I'm pointing at the camera right now and to there. Anyway, I think this has been kind of
pretty good, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'd say for, laptops having quite a bit of criticism for the built-in components. These are decent built-in components, and it's so far a decent device. I'll be curious to hear, I'm sure we'll talk more about it this weekend or our next podcast, the impressions that you get. I also have probably a little bit more impressions of the iPad Pro, the iPad Pro month now, because I have been using it more in the last couple of days that I had previously. And I'm also trying to make it my office computer in a sense when I go to the office and I'm only going to be there for an hour or two and I don't feel like toting my laptop along with me, which included me turning on the nebulous setting for more space that I did not realize was in the display settings. Yeah, there's a more space option under display zoom that I had never really thought about until this last couple days.
Are you going to set up a second display in your office since your new iPad can do an extended display?
I may try that. So it's all about, can I actually do work? And man, I've had to do some boxing to get files where I want them and things like that. So there's been some jabbing and sparring with my computer, but we'll see. I'm hopeful that I can do some fun stuff over the next few weeks that I'm teaching so that when I go back in the fall full time, I have some plans for things other than always having to have a full MacBook with me.
By the way, I'm going to switch back to my Yeti Nano microphone just for another comparison for as we finish up this mini podcast. You know, one thing I've literally not had a chance to play with this except to set up Google Meet. Well, I had to download Google Chrome because I thought it worked better than an Edge, and you know, set up a meeting and plug in my microphone and things like that. So I really haven't done anything. I did set up my Android phone to via its phone link or whatever the app is, but set up right now so I can use it as a camera, which Sven showed us using a phone. So. But I haven't set up to do that. Otherwise, I would have tested that too. The one thing I did want to say is this Surface runs way hotter than I expected. Coming from M1 MacBook Air and M2 and M4 iPads, which run really cool. I don't know if it's because I've had Google Meet running this whole time. You know, video conference software tends to really push the processor. But I have an infrared thermometer, and it's clocking in at 107 degrees at the back of the Surface. Fortunately, you know, one of the fortunate things is, you know, unlike a conventional laptop, when they run hot, it's uncomfortable to use because, you know, the lap part is the part that's hot. Since the Surface is a separate computing device. The screen is the computing device versus, you know, under the keyboard. The keyboard, of course, itself is cool. So, you know, that's a good thing, but I could not believe how hot when I touched it just to kind of prop it up in a different way. And I was like, wow, it's uncomfortable to touch. Mm-hmm. It was just about 107 degrees using an infrared thermometer. And I could hear a fan running, which I did not expect to do.
Interesting.
Yeah, I thought maybe if I did like video processing, like, you know, processing a 360 degree video or something, but wow, I didn't expect just Google Meet to heat it up.
You know, now that you bring up, and I might have to do this and report back on a full mobile views, I have one of those thermometers as well.
Yeah.
And my iPad mini, which I take to read outside sometimes, overheats very quickly in, you know, 100 degree weather.
Oh, okay.
And I really should start tracking because it's about 20 minutes and it will start lowering its screen brightness and it'll start turning itself off. And you don't think about heat sometimes with devices that normally run very cool. I mean, I'm pointing this thermometer at the iPad Pro and it's at 87 degrees Fahrenheit.
Which is, so it's just, you know, pretty good. Not 107 like mine.
Yeah.
My Surface Pro. Yeah, you know, I did have I have had thermal shutdown on older iPhones. It went back when my daughter was in high school, and she used to run cross country and track and field both. And you know, we'd be sitting out in the hot, well, not necessarily the hot sun, but in the hot outside, right? Maybe in the shade, but still hot. And I had a thermal shutdown on my phone a couple times, and my Pixel 7a. Maybe it was the 4, the previous 4, but one of these phones, I know that I was doing some in-person podcast recordings. It was with my friend Paul Lawler, who I think you've spoken with on a podcast. Mm-hmm. And we were just sitting down in a shade. It was maybe 80 degrees. So it was warm, but not uncomfortably so. But I was recording to the Pixel, and it said, "Hey, I'm overheating. I'm ready to shut down." So we ended the podcast.
Yeah, it's interesting when we used to, I think a lot more about the thermal envelopes of the things that we were using, and then it stopped being a concern because of desktop and mobile device cooling, laptop cooling. But now it really is a more of a concern because of mobile devices that we don't think about too much. I've had overheating, but I typically see it at the beach. Yeah, I take my phone or my iPad, read. That's not going to work very long, which actually means that, ironically, the best device I have to listen to music on the beach is my Apple Watch, because it won't overheat, and I can stream to my AirPods from the Apple Watch.
I've never done that. I think I don't have enough storage in my Apple Watch Series 6. Before I let you go, I should note that this is a Wednesday, July 3rd. We usually record on a Sunday morning. I was able to catch John after his work hours and some other things he had to run today. So I want to thank him for, putting up with my foolishness as usual to help me test this. I do want to note that two more things before I let you go, and for the our fives of podcast listeners, I did not get the fancy dancy $350 whatever Flex keyboard. I've got the one that attaches to the Surface connector. It's an okay keyboard with a touchpad, and it comes with a Surface Pen combo. So I've got the keyboard. I've got a Surface Pen, which I have not tried yet, except to activate and to charge up. But other than that, I haven't done anything with it, and I've verified that it works. Sort of used it to select a couple of menu items. Any rate, so right now we're using the front-facing camera of the Microsoft Surface Pro. I guess 11 is what they call it. But I've switched to the Yeti Nano, and I'm going to just switch back one more time to the Array microphone. Okay, so we're back to the Array microphone and the Surface Pro camera as we get through MobileViews Mini Podcast 45, doing the audio and camera tests for the Microsoft Surface Pro Copilot Plus PC 11. They got to come up with shorter names.
Yeah, well, it's Microsoft. You're just lucky that there's not Community Edition Preview, Beta 7 Whistler, Chicago, Minneapolis, Australia, Contoso.
There you go. Okay, as usual, thank you to the good Dr. Jon Westfall. And this is MiniViews Podcast number 45. We'll see you next time.